Hello everybody, I am Arun Narasimhan, a postdoctoral researcher at Cold Spring Harbor Labs. I am interested in understanding the function of brain. In order to understand the function of brain, we need to be able to observe it and follow it for a long period of time. There are many techniques that can be used. One such technique which I am going to be talking about is called fluorescence microscopy. So fluorescence microscopy is a combination of a microscopy technique and a fluorescent tagging mechanism, both of which I will explain during my talk. The human body is made up of many, many billions of cells. These cells are very small. They are about 1/10 to 100 the size of human hair, which is one of the smallest objects naked eye can see. So in order to observe these cells, we need to be able to magnify them. This magnification process is called microscopy. What is a microscope? Everybody would have come across the magnifying glass during their school days. A magnifying glass is used to enlarge objects, say, for example, bugs or leaves. So a microscope is a combination of many more magnifying glasses in order to magnify much smaller objects into more finer details. So in order to elucidate the power of microscope, I will give you an example of a mint leaf. The following video shows how powerful the microscope is. Say, for example, when you see through your naked eye, you can see the leaves and the stem. When you put the leaf under a microscope and start zooming in, the right-hand side shows the number of times it has been zoomed. You start to see finer structures within the leaves. You start to see the secondary hair. And when you start to zoom in further, you start to see the small blobs. These are basically the mint essence. So now we have a technique microscope which can actually zoom objects and you will be able to see in finer details. But how do you identify your region of interest? Or how do you focus within a particular tissue and see a certain specific cell? It is analogous to where's the Waldo series. How do you identify the Waldo? The identification mechanism is done by fluorescence. So what is fluorescence? Fluorescence is a process in which certain molecules absorb light and then they re-emit it in a longer wavelength. Everybody would have come across this glow-in-the-dark stickers and these running jackets. These are based on the principle of fluorescence, so that they glow in, they absorb light in the day and then they glow in the night. Fluorescence occurs in nature too. Jellyfish fluoresces to attract prey. Scientists were interested in this fluorescence and they isolated the molecules that was responsible for the fluorescence. It fluoresced in green in color, so it was called green fluorescent protein. Scientists are very unimaginative naming things. Further, many more scientists were able to tag this fluorescent protein to certain regions, say, for example, cells within a tissue, or certain specific proteins within the cell. And when these cells or tissues were put in the microscope, you could actually see them glow. I will show you what we do in our lab. The example here is shown as a region of brain tissue of a mouse. So what you see in the green color is the cells that are active during a certain process. And there are many other cells here which are not active during the same process. So what we can do is take the image of the whole brain and reconstruct it, and then you could get a functional connectivity during that particular activity. Another example I would like to show is within the cell, you could tag various regions of interest. Say the nucleus can be tagged in violet, and the cytoskeleton can be tagged in red, and then you tag the peroxisomes in green color, and then see how the cell is behaving during a particular process. Say when you target the drug can be targeted with a fluorescent molecule, and then you can observe how the drug interacts with the cell. I hope I have been able to convince you of the power of fluorescence microscope. As they say, seeing is believing. Thank you.